So today we're going to start with something a little different.
It's a vehicle, but it's a recreational vehicle. To be exact, it's a Boles Aero from 1963. This is you're trying to get, I'm going to have two or three parts to this also. I'm not going to just do one. I can't do it all in one video. But if you're buying an RV back in the early 60s, these guys were in direct competition with people like Airstream, and they did a great job on building a really killer RV, travel trailer, whatever you call it there. And this one has been pretty well taken care of for most of its life. It's a one owner. Just put a set of brand new tires on it. We did get rid of the split rims and put some Toyota wheels on it. But I mean, look at this thing. It's pretty freaking amazing. We're just gonna run around the outside real quick, and then we'll go look inside real briefly. And part two and part three, we'll show you some updates that we've done. Your typical storage. Missing a couple little reverse lights here, which let's try to find those. But this side's pretty cool too. And in the next couple parts, I'm gonna open up all the little compartments and we'll go over what's inside all those. But this is a pretty clean shape. Your power heater, furnace thingy. The gold accents, I think, for Boles was really a good idea back in the day. The jealousy windows, the curved front living room windows. How amazing is that? Now, like I said, this thing's in surprisingly very good shape. Luckily, it's been in Arizona pretty much its whole life. So really, we don't get a lot of rain. So yeah, it has moisture damage from the roof, but it's not as bad as some things I've seen. So when we do part two and part three, we're gonna show stuff we fixed, like the glass. We're gonna look inside the little compartments outside. We're even right here, there's supposed to be a screen door, which I have out getting fixed right now. That's the original lock. There's your step. There's some linoleum right there. You walk in, couch immediately to your right, with your storage compartments underneath. The original drapes look original to me. Could be wrong, but they look original. The roof is, yeah, coming down, as you can see. Wouldn't be hard to fix the leak, but we might try to do that this weekend, actually. We're gonna go on the roof and see what's up. It's got like the original hardware. You gotta push the little button there. In your hat, your little portable table there. So look to your left, and here is your kitchenette, AC unit, closet for miscellaneous whatever when you walk in there. I love the 70s feel, man, or the 60s feel. Stove's actually in nice shape. I'm assuming this all works. We haven't tested it yet, but we will. We're gonna test this plumbing also in the near future. So here's our fridge and freezer. It's actually really nice shape. I believe this is also propane or electric on the freezer, the fridge. Got a little latch right here, locks it so they don't open on you. Freezer. They thought of everything. So, there's our cabinets up here. The original plastic fake tile backsplash. From what I understand, you could get these with either teal or yellow fixtures. This one obviously got the yellow. Can't see in there, it's underneath the sink. That'll have to be for next part. Linoleum old floors.
some hardwood in here look pretty cool. Again, here's a closet space. I think you could do a lot with this that they didn't do back in the day. A little bit more ceiling damage. Some more cabinets above. This would be a sleeping area. Little twin bed there. Storage underneath. Storage on this side. Another twin bed spot. More storage up here. It's going to be hard to see because of the lighting. The original curtains. Some more lighting. This will look great when we get it lit up. I plug it in, you'll see. A little pocket door right here. So there's the other door to go out. Right next to the bed. Bathroom. Your sink. Toilet. Mirrors. Lighting. More storage. You've got a lot of closet space. I think you do some of this closet space, probably do something else with it. This shower, that's broken, has a tub, which is pretty cool. Get a tub. The original fixtures and everything. Yeah, it's a little dirty, but man. Yeah, it's a porcelain tub. Maybe it's plastic, I don't know. But how cool is this, man? This ceiling back here is actually pretty clean. I think this can be left alone. Depends on how you want to deal with it, how far you want to go restore with it. All the floors. Let's see. Now, let's go back up. Floors again, there's your sleeping quarters. Roof, ceiling, whatever you want to call it. A little vent. Pop. You see some moisture damage there too. Okay, so redo this roof, guys. Here's your privacy curtain. So, like I said, next couple of parts of this, we'll go over things a little bit more specifically. But mainly outside, all the little compartments do, and what's still there, what's missing, maybe not there. Here's your living room area to entertain your friends. You know what? I could just see camping in this thing. Open up the curtains, have it lit up at night. How cool. AC unit again. Can't wait to light this up, plug it in. It's gonna look so nice. I mean, I want to restore more of it, but somebody might have their own idea how they want to restore it. So maybe, you know, sometimes it's better just let some other people do it their own way. That lighting's pretty cool for its time. It's an old fluorescent light in there. But there's your 1963 Boles Aero, folks. And that's part one. Now the sun's kind of gone down. I think this is about 20, 23 feet right around there, maybe including the hitch. Obviously it's a dual axle. But there's inside there, I think was part of the furnace maybe, if I'm not mistaken. Plug that in. Your extra door. Back door. Hey, cat. Just really neat stuff. Obviously, some plumbing stuff going on there. Clean outs, so to speak. Oh, I wonder what went on there. That's kind of cool. I'll have to look and see. Ooh, cable for the modern people. Which now would just be satellite, right? Also
Also, I got a build sheet on this from the Boles family. They have a build sheet on this. And I'll show you that in the next part two or part three. It shows how it was built with all the options and stuff. It's kind of cool. So it shows a little bit of history. And look at that curved glass, plexiglass. You can actually see how your particular Boles was built back in the day off in the build sheet. And I'm working on getting that from the Boles family right now. But again, that's it. See you on part two. And
the light in there.
Oh, there is a light in there. How cool. This thing needs LEDs like crazy. We'll see you on part two and part three in the near future. Thanks for watching. See you soon, guys.